You may find a small canister attached with your bike suspension leg. But what is it? And how this type of suspension system is different from conventional suspensions? Stay tuned with us, we are having Anshu. You may be knowing this small canister, or usually said, a small cylinder is filled with nitrogen gas. And sometimes it's called a nitrox suspension. And a hydropneumatic suspension in terms of physics. This is a redefined version of conventional spring suspensions. Now let's get into it. Let us first eliminate the spring. We will discuss later on why the spring is required. So now we are having a piston inside a cylinder that is filled with a fluid, normally the hydraulic fluid. This fluid is very less compressible and will directly transfer the impact to the chassis if the piston is not incorporated with some valves. These valves get open when fluid is pressurized during any impact, and fluid transferred from this chamber. This small canister is filled up with nitrogen gas at around 50 psi of pressure. Nitrogen is filled because it is non-corrosive in nature. Oil and the nitrogen gas never get mixed up because gas is inside the canister with thick walls. Now, if your vehicle faces any impact, the piston moves up and this canister squeezes up and your bike is less subjected to shock damage. This nitrogen gas absorbs excessive force. This was the use of this small canister that comes up with your bike suspension leg. But here a question arises, why the spring is given if we can have a better suspension with this? So the reason is, along with providing a comfort ride, the spring protects the tire from excessive wear. As the rear wheel is rotating on high speed, sometimes it gets in air, and now if spring is not there, the wheel will hit the ground rotating at high speed. In this way, wheel is under exertion of excessive wear. But if we are having springs along with this, these springs ensure tire contact with ground all the times and never let it in the air for even a second. So if the spring is not there, you may need to change your tire every week. Now I think it is clearly understood. But still, if you have some doubt, leave me a comment in comment section. Hit the like button and definitely the subscribe so that you never miss a video.